Now let's test the new permission classes that we've assigned to our view set. Minimize the Atom editor and double check that the development server is running on our Vagrant box. You can see that it's still running here. So I'm going to minimize this and head over to Chrome. Click on the URL and hit enter to reload the page. You can see that we've now lost the option to create new status updates. This is because of the is authenticated or read only permission. Because we're not logged in anymore, we've lost the option to create new items because we can only read items unless we authenticate it. So let's re-enable the authentication header and then reload the page. If you scroll down, you can see that we've got the status text input back. Let's just type hello test status and make sure that it works. All right, so you can see that it successfully created a new status item for us. Let's add the ID of this newly created status update to the end of the URL. And let's make sure we can modify the status as the logged in user who created it. So let's just say we want to add update and click put. You can see that it's updated the status text. All right, so now we know that that works. Let's test creating a new user and trying to modify another user's status update. So I'm going to uncheck the authorization header here, and I'm going to head over to the base of our API. Actually, we can click this API root here. And then I'm going to click on profile. And we're going to scroll down to the bottom, and I'm going to create a new user. I'm going to give it the email address test@londonappdeveloper.com. And we'll give him the name Terry Letesta. We'll give it the password awesome1 with a capital A. Hit post to create the new user profile. I got an error saying that this test email address already exists. So I'm going to choose a different email address like test1 and hit post. All right, so now it's created our new user for Terry Letesta. Let's log in as that user so we can test if we can modify other people's status updates. So go back to the API root and click on the login URL. We're gonna add the username test1@londonappdeveloper.com. And we're gonna use the password that I used, which was awesome1 with a capital A. And hit post to log in as the user. It's generated a new token for this user. So let's copy the contents of that token, copy, and let's load up mod header. And I'm gonna click the plus sign to add a new request header. In the name of the header, I'm gonna type authorization, just like above. And I'm gonna type token. I'm gonna paste the new token. Make sure that the other authorization token is unchecked and the new one is checked so that we log in with the new user. Go back to the page and go back to the API root. From the API root, click on the feed page. This will take us to the feeds, and we can see here that there's these status updates that were created by user profile 1. That was the administrator user that we used to create these status updates. So let's try and modify one of these by entering the ID of that, of let's say the first one, so ID 1. Hit enter. We can view the page, but we don't have the options to edit. That's because the permissions failed because we aren't trying to modify a status update with this user profile that we're currently logged in as. So it looks like our user profile permissions are working correctly. All right, so that's how we test the permissions using the Chrome interface. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next lesson.